I'm gonna want explanations, you know. For example, what the hell happened to Rose? She's seriously messed up now.
The same thing I think happened to me after I arrived.
During this week you can't remember?
Oh, I remember now. Barry was in his element, making calls, making things happen, even if he didn't entirely know what those things were. He wouldn't let the hot sheriff chick down. Even if every noise he heard from outside, and he heard plenty, made him jump. He had only paused to text Al a message, told him to hurry up. Suddenly, Barry froze in mid-dial. A window broke somewhere in the building, and then the lights went out.
Over here! There's light! I have a key. Watch my back, Wade.
It's an ambush.
Awake. Okay, someone's messed with the fuse box here, but you should be able to jury-rig it while I find the keys.
I already got electrocuted once today. How about I look for the keys and you get burned for a change?
Fine. They should be in the clerk's office on the other side of the building, near the main entrance.
The darkness that wore Barbara Jagger's face was furious. The story in the manuscript had been making it stronger all the time, but now the light had set the writer free and hurt it, weakened it. It was only a matter of days before the dark presence would be strong again, but meanwhile, it would be difficult to recapture the writer. The message was from Barry. He was getting worried at the station. He wanted us to hurry.
Okay, Sheriff, I got the keys.
Barry?
Why isn't he inside?
Oh, God! Oh, God!
Sidewake. He's okay. The storefront's blocked. Come on, Wake. Let's go around. We can meet him in the back.
Barry? Barry! Can you hear me? Are you okay in there?
Yeah, I'm cool. Don't worry. I'll find another way out and meet you two out back.
Are you sure?
I'm fine. Besides, there's all sorts of useful stuff in here. I didn't touch that. I wasn't anywhere near that.
Thank you.
We can make it through the bookstore. Hey, Wheeler should be waiting for
people?
Us in the backyard.
Keep the hell down or I'll call the sheriff.
Oh, hi, Doc. I've got it. Don't worry about it.
Sarah, about time somebody showed up. All the shooting in the air is idiotic. One of these days, they'll kill somebody. And over Deerfest.
I know. Go back to bed. He's got a point, Wake. Look, this town can't take this.
They're really taking advantage of your presence here, Wake. I heard they're selling a lot of your Alex Casey books.
Right now, I'm not a big fan of my own writing. Cynthia Weaver worked hard, following her obsessive rituals, sometimes fighting them, always giving in to them in the end. She haunted the halls of Brightfalls' abandoned power plant. She marked her caches with light-sensitive paint that could only be seen by eyes that had been touched by darkness and saved by light like she'd been. She was preparing defenses and supply lines for the war she knew would come. The war between the forces of light and darkness.
I don't see Barry.
Look, Wake, maybe that's him. That's the way to the chopper.
Barry got back to his feet inside the Brightfalls General Store and dusted himself off. Right next to the cans of baked beans was a locked case filled with flare guns, and yet here was a conveniently placed barrel of crowbars. Barry's smile widened as he realized that this was the classic movie scene where the hero had to gear up and arm himself to the teeth. Barry threw himself into the role.
I'm gonna give Pastor Howard a piece of my mind about this lock. Ugh! I told him to get it fixed.
Here they come.
Let's take a break.
Keep an eye out! I lost that one!
Barry got back to his feet inside the Brightfalls.
I'm gonna give Pastor Howard a piece of my mind about this lock. I told him to get it fixed.
Here they come.
Labor. Let's take a break.
Okay, it's open. Let's go, Wake.
Wow.
We keep them lit all night long on the night before Gearfest.
Why?
Well, it's tradition.
For it to be free, the Dark Presence needed the writer to finish the story. Again and again, the story let it get frustratingly close to the writer without letting it capture him. It was bound by the events depicted in the manuscript, but it could pursue the writer indirectly, put others on the task, and stop those who would help him. It took over everything in its path, made them its puppets, and sent them after Alan Wake.
We're almost there. We'll have to go through the basement to get to the parking lot.
Yeah, there's no way going through the crypt will turn out to be a bad idea.
Did you call 911?
Guess that one saw the light, huh? You didn't like that one? A tough audience. Well, I got plenty more.
What are the Christmas lights for?
Protection, man! Like garlic against vampires?
Vampires.
The helicopter's just across the parking lot and up the hill. Come on!
The Brightfalls General Store is now my favorite place in the entire world. See this headlamp? It's like a superpower. I can just look at one of those things and they die. It's my flaming eye of Mordor.
I wish I didn't say that.
Yeah.
Hey, I want a headlamp.
Last one.
Bastard.
Alice had screamed until she had no voice left to scream. Around her, the darkness was alive. It was cold and wet and malevolent and without end. She was a prisoner, trapped in the dark place. The terror would have burned her mind out, but one thing made her hang on. She could sense Alan in the dark. She could hear him. She could see the words he was writing as flickering shadows. He sensed her too. He was trying to work his way to her.
Someone throws a damn school bus at your head and you're about to take a helicopter ride with someone who may or may not have a pilot's license. You're cleared for departure to Night Springs. No offense, Sheriff.
Just up ahead. I'll need a while to prep for takeoff.
Don't take too long. I want to get out of here.
Thank you.
hands on a local crazy lady, Al. I hope you're right about her, or we can kiss this town goodbye.
I had to do something about the chain for the door to open. Thank you.
And here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock legends, the Old Gods. I couldn't tell you why. I guess it's just, one of those things. Anyway, here's Poets of the Fall and their latest single, War.
This is good work for a night, person.
Glowed in the night. It was close, but I had to find a way across.
Thank you.
Making her way through the water pipe alone, Cynthia was angry at the rider. Foolish young man, taking unnecessary risks. And the way he broke the rules. Didn't he understand what was at stake? Since the terrible days in the 70s, she hadn't wavered once, as hard as it had been. She was tired of protecting the town all these long years, and now only wanted to rest. The story I had written in the cabin had come true. Touched by the dark presence, I had written a horror story. But the end was still missing. The story was incomplete, and the last unfinished page of the manuscript still sat in the typewriter in the cabin study. If I could get back there, if I could read the page, then I could write my own ending to this story and save Alice.
Thank you. It's like it isn't there, but... Oh, I can't look straight at it.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Start. Completely blocked now. I
I recognized the logo on the power plant sign. I'd seen a version of it painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Weaver! Cynthia! I'm a friend!
Prove it!
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song! You can help me!
About time! Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you.
It's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you need to drive the darkness back. Lit room is at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
Oh, we won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking the rules, young man, and where has that gotten us, Oh, I have a secret route, a lit route, an old water pipe. Something was damaged at the transformer yard. All the reserve power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. The kill switch is outside. I have been preparing for these times. The dark tides. You have found my caches, haven't you? You can see the signs. Very few people can. Yes, please. Take what you need. This is all for you, for the likes of us. We do Tom's work, don't we?
Hurry! The switch is on the wall facing the shore.
Cannot take you to the well-lit room if the lights in the pipe go out. You must go outside to use the emergency switch.
Sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her to help me. I hoped Weaver was dependable. I'd stumbled into this crazy world a little over a week ago. She had been living this insanity for decades. I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it. designs these things. The transformer yard went dark and dead. Weaver's water pipe passage should now be good to go.
This way, young man. Follow me. Come, come. The pipe's empty now. We're ready to go. This way. We need to go. I knew them both, Tom and Barbara. I had such a crush on him. Such a beautiful man. I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident. And then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring her back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. The witch looked like her, but it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. Oh, he was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. Oh, Tom. He left only one thing behind in my care, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room and put it there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story you have written, and none of us will survive to see the end of it if the darkness isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own dark ends.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me, you know, in television, from beyond, from below. We have both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both with light, but the darkness stays with you. Use a stain.
The
this pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
It's Sarah now? We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.